Hey there, YouTube. Today I'm proud to present to you 2010 Audi A8 D4 generation. In this video, I'm going to show you the interior swastika exterior of this car. This car has V8 4.2 liter. It produces 372 horsepower. And size, here's the key. Let's start the engine. Let it run for a while. Lock and lock and power trunk button. Absolutely incredible Audi space frame, very safe car, smart key access system, of course, chrome handles, door handles, very solid doors, and also soft closing doors, of course, like so, wide opening. Black leather interior, extremely comfortable seats, absolutely awesome. Faux spoke design, fully wrapped steering wheel, stitched airbag cover. Alrighty, guys, let's hop on in. Awesome. And there's two ways you can start this beautiful Audi A8. Just insert the key to that slot and press on it. Quite easy. The mirrors fall out. And another way to start this car, so to speak, put the foot on brake and then hit button start right here. It's quite easy. This particular has 14,569 kilometers in it. Side bolsters is activated right here. Extremely comfortable seats. Of course, power tilt and telescoping. Heated steering wheel. High quality leather. Sport grips up top. Some wear right here. Electrically assisted power steering and loud horn, of course. This car has automatic lights and automatic rain sensing windshield wipers. Right now, it's in the headlight. Front head fog lights, of course. High beam. Small search lights right here. Your central lock. Two-person memory for the steering column and for the driver seat, as well as the passenger seat. Awesome. Park steering mirrors, they also heated. Use this joystick to adjust. Not bad. And of course, power folding, like I showed you before. Beautiful feature. All four windows in this car fully automatic in both directions, up and down. Double paint windows for a better sound isolation. And child safety locks. Not bad. Alcantara and some storage compartment. Land felt. High quality soft leather. Rich wood grain. Aluminum. It's all plastic, of course. Right now, let's open the hood and take a look at the exterior score. Alright, let's open the hood. It's quite easy. This car doesn't have power moonroof, chrome accent window frames. It's all aluminum body. And here's your antenna for your audio, LED third brake light. Dual polished exhaust pipes, LED inserts, awesome. Rear parking assist, lot of chrome, license plate lights, and your rear view camera located right here. Fuel certified injection and legendary Quattro 4x4 system. Tow hook located right here. 18-inch rims, tires measuring 235-55, front ventilated disc brakes, inner also ventilated disc brakes, Continental Conti Sport Contact 5 tires, wheel locks. Alright guys, now I'm going to show you underneath of this car. LED turn signal assist, streamers, very bright, and of course LED welcome lights. Your VIN number, and there is no crack or imperfection on the windshield, good sign. This car has bi-xenon projector headlights, LED daytime running lights. On top trim, full LED headlights is available. Absolutely gorgeous car, inside and out. Headlight washers right here, front parking assist. Absolutely stunning Audi grille, Quattro. This car has V8, a 32 valve, dual head cam, 4.2 liter normally aspirated engine. It produced 372 horsepower and 445 Nm of torque. Maximum speed is electronically limited to 150 km per hour. 0-6 time is 5.7 seconds. Combined fuel consumption for this car is around 13.5 liters per 100 km. Main rivals for this car is a Jaguar XJ, of course BMW 7 Series, Mercedes-Benz S-Class, and Lexus LS Series. The trunk space is around 510 liters. The fuel tank is around 9 liters. 8-speed automatic transmission, 4-wheel drive quattro system, multi-link air suspension up front and multi-link air suspension out back, front ventilated disc brakes and rear also ventilated disc brakes. The third generation of the Audi 8 was introduced in Miami in November 2009. The chassis was built on the Volkswagen D4 platform. Of course, different engines are available. 2-liter hybrid TFSI, it produced 211 horsepower. 3-liter TFSI Quattro, it produced 290 horsepower. 3-liter TFSI Quattro, it produced 333 horsepower. 4-liter 420 horsepower and 435 horsepower. In our case, it's a 4.2 liter, it produced 372 horsepower. Then top of line W12 6.3 liter, it produced 500 horsepower. S version, of course, it produced with 4 liter engine, TFSI Quattro, 520 horsepower. And top of line S8 Plus, 4 liter TFSI Quattro, it produced 605 horsepower. And diesel engines, 3 liter TDI, it produced 204 horsepower, 3 liter TDI, it produced 250 horsepower, and top of line, 4.2 liter TDI Quattro, it produced 350 horsepower. New features, changes include full LED headlamps with automatic high beam switching or Audi adaptive light xenon with variable headlight range control, enhanced MMI with touchpad and handwriting recognition for the phone and navigation system, using NVIDIA Tegra system on a chip for very high processing speed, optional 1400 watt Bang & Olufsen sound system, driver assistance systems networked using FlexRide technology, hard disk drive and GPS navigation with 3D computer graphic with Google Earth, navigation system coordinates input to the adaptive headlights, transmission, adaptive cruise control and electronic stability control, B
broadband internet with UMTS 3G and WLNA hotspot. All models include an 8-speed Tiptronic automatic transmission. As you can see, guys, this car is very nicely equipped. Alright guys, right now, take a good look at the exterior, let's take a good look at the interior portion, the most interesting part on this beautiful car. Your vents right here for the alarm, speakers, boot trunk release right there, tire pressure. And of course, turn off the alarm. Very nice attention to the details. Aluminum entry guards. Driver seat has spark adjustment. Magnet center, of course. Four-way ball lumbar. Side bolsters and sliding seat high, upper portion and lower portion. And recline adjustable headrests and seatbelts, of course. 16-way power seats, not bad, somewhere right here, but it's a pretty common situation. Here the steering wheel, right here, button, panel dim, and headlight controls. Of course, your pedals with LED illumination, OBD and fuse box right here. Clean floor, 8 factory floor mats. And of course your cruise control settings right here. Alrighty guys, right now let's see what kind of noise this beautiful engine produces. Well, definitely not bad. Revlimbs around 4000 RPM. Red nettles. Easy to read gauges indeed. And of course your paddle shifters right here, plus for the upshift, minus for the downshift. Light naked controls, high gloss back finish, and of course your intermittent wiper controls and your parking lights, I believe. Driver information system, different settings, as you can see, average and current fuel economy, distance to empty. Audio information. That's pretty much it. And of course your voice commands, your navigation, you can increase and decrease the volume. Overall build quality and all the materials just top-notch. Of course stitched this portion, leather wrapped Audi MMI system. You can hide this way. Audi MMI multimedia interface, aluminum, beautiful analog clock, for the rear sunshade, turn off the parking sensors, turn off the traction stability, DVD, SD card, dual zone, fully automatic climate control, heated seats, three stage, high, medium, low enough for the driver and for the passenger, fan speed control right here. Individual settings, something incredible. Then of course your temperature adjustment right here, front view defrost, air conditioning on and off, recycle, sync, automatic mode, different modes. That's pretty much it for this beautiful dual zone climate control. A lot of wood, aluminum, Audi MMI system. That's your main menu for the car, for the tone, radio, media, settings, car, comfort mode, auto, dynamic, individual, information, radio, media, jukebox, SD card, and DVD. Tone, you can increase and decrease the volume right here, and of course, turn it off. Dial pad. Awesome, very easy to use. Soft leather wrapped, feels like a pillow, I hear. Absolutely stunning. See convenient cup holders, power supply. Come on, thing is broken. Nope. Electronic parking brake with auto hold function. To engage it, just pull, and to disengage, put your foot on brake and then press on it. It's quite easy. 8-speed silky smooth automatic transmission. Hit the low button, drive, S mode, reverse, rear view camera with guidance lines, of course, trajectory, you can change the view, graphic, not bad. And hit the lock, P for park. It's quite easy. That's pretty much it. Of course, adjustable armrest. Good sensor down here. Line of felt. This feeling absolutely incredible. And there is no wear or imperfection right here. Good sign also. Auto dim rear view mirror. Sunglass container is also padded right here. Beautiful LED map lights, motion sensors, and microphone for the hands-free. Not bad. So, your sun visors, vent mirror with LED illumination, plus your car holder, handles up top, and ambient lighting, side curtain airbags.
This car feels like, I don't know, like a Bentley sometimes, but more affordable. Good looking. Affordable right now, pre-owned. But it's not cheap to buy and cheap to run, that's for sure. Plus, oil consumption is not so good for this car. Sometimes it's just a pain in the ass. So, right now, let's check back seats, shall we? My gosh, those seats are extremely comfortable. And really expensive suspension. I mean, if it's a air suspension, it's for sure expensive, but it's all aluminum arms, so on and so forth. It's not cheap to maintain. Alrighty guys, so let's check back seats. Same high quality materials, aluminum entry parts. All right, but my 63 statue is quite easy to get in and out. An ashtray, speakers, and of course your rims, illumination, cut hook, rope handles up top, central lock, of course sunshade control. It's quite easy, as you can see, for privacy. And of course your shades right here.
windows. And also you can control this side for the shade and for the window. Not bad. For extra privacy. Of course your search bucket. A lot of wood. Central tunnel, huge by the way. Power supply or ashtray or vans. 3-stage heated seats, but it's not cooled. I believe an Optrum cooled seats is available. High, medium, low enough for the driver and for the passenger. I'm sorry, for the rear passengers. It's quite obvious. So your central armrest and first aid kit, like it right here. Factory first aid kit. Awesome. Line of felt, very deep. Storage compartment and shelf, extra shelf right here, I believe, with ventilation. Some storage and of course convenient cup holders. That's pretty much it. As you can see, back visibility is pretty good as far as I'm concerned. Seats are just a masterpiece. Awesome seats. Exquisite Audi A8 interior. Feels awesome. Beautiful. Alrighty guys, right now let's check trunk space, shall we? I'm gonna shut down the engine. Alrighty. Thank you. power trunk. Good size, by the way. Illumination. Factory 8 formats. And trunk is pretty good. So your spare tire, only donut, tools and jack, titans, grocery back hex, it's all aluminum. Warning triangle is missing, as you can see. Your fuel cap, premium a little fuel only, of course. I believe there is an illumination right here. Same power adjustment for passenger seat. Warning, VIN number. And storage compartment right here. Storage net, same soft materials, well wrapped, beautiful. Two-person memory, central lock, and power window. Glove box is lockable, very deep, linen felt. Your card holder, pen holder, sunglass container, I believe, and very deep glove box, as you can see. It's also cool to air conditioning. Extra shelf right here and right there. And here's your manuals, it's all Russian specification, of course. Feels very solid, even it's beautiful. Manuals. This car is so fun to drive, but fuel economy sucks. And at the same time, oil consumption is not so good. Nothing feels like an Audi. Alright guys, hope you enjoy my in-depth look. It is absolutely stunning. 2010 Audi A8 D4. Thanks for watching, thanks for sharing, for subscribing. Truly appreciate it. Take care guys.